人間に接触するとその負の感情を吸収し、ついにはダークドラゴンになってしまう。バーンザウィッチ。
So things were just crazy today. In case she wasn't on the internet today, Burn the Witch 0.8, which is going to get an adaptation, which is the prologue to Burn the Witch Season 1, is going to be adapted by Studio Colorado, the same staff that did Season 1 of Burn the Witch, and they're doing the prologue, which is the first one-shot chapter from 2018 for Jump's 50th anniversary. And this is absolutely huge because nobody was really expecting it to be dropped, especially of today of all days. I was watching the Bleach anime on Japanese TV, TV Tokyo, as I usually do on Discord with a bunch of people. I like to watch the adverts throughout the episodes because I just, it's a guilty pleasure of mine to watch the adverts unironically. And then all of a sudden, you just hear Nini's voice or Noelle's, I can't remember off the top of my head. And I was just like, oh, I just thought it was like something Shueisha based. And then boom, we see Noelle. And then my first instinct was, oh, like, are they re-showing like some Burn the Witch like episodes? And I was like, no, that's from the one. Noelle is wearing an outfit from the one shot. And then it showed the footage that you will see on screen now. And I was just like, my brain didn't compute and just wow. And then of course I had to upload the reaction to the Bleach episode. So where we are now, what does this mean? I'm pretty sure a lot of you have questions about what it's all about. Well, of course, I've always said Season 2 of Burn the Witch is going to be happening. I've spoken about it on Twitter a few times, very vaguely, that we will be getting a Season 2 of Burn the Witch. So this definitely caught me by surprise because I didn't actually expect Chapter 0 to get adapted, because a lot of things that was in Chapter 0 was implemented within Episode 1 to 3 of Burn the Witch Season 1, right? So that was something I actually didn't really expect. And the more I thought about it throughout the day, I think I have a grasp on what's actually going to be happening here in specifically. But before I talk about the marketing process and where I think this is going to be going into the future, let's talk about this trailer in specifically. And there's a few things that caught my attention. Of course, obviously the starting out of the trailer is exactly how it started out within Chapter 0. But there are a few original scenes within this chapter or episode, whatever we want to call it. And that is Nini and Noelle running away from the paparazzi. That was never in the Chapter 0, obviously chapter. And then we also have Nini throwing like a kick and then doing like her head back, like throwing her head back like she's talking to someone, probably Noelle. That wasn't in the chapter. And there's this like really interesting like dark scene of like Noelle and Nini's reaction where the daytime is dark. Now, of course, I would say, oh, well, maybe they're fighting one of the dragons. But of course, we get to see one of these dragons like literally in the next shot and it's like daytime. And this kind of looks nighttime. So I'm imagining that we have three different new shots within this trailer as a whole. And that's really good and really interesting. As I said, there's going to be a few things that are going to be moved around here. And I think we are going to get maybe a lot of original content within this episode. So I'm very excited to see what they're going to implement. I think the baseline story is going to be exactly the same. How everybody met up, how Balgo turned into how Balgo turned into what he is, how Asushi became what they became to be, and how they got attached to Noelle and Nini, etc, etc. So, just for the memes, is this at the point where TJ is dating Nini? Will we see their breakup? Who knows? Maybe this is like the start, and I will be very happy to see that, because then she can get with me. But, other than that, all jokes aside, what do I see? I mean, besides this trailer looking absolutely gorgeous, right? It just does. It looks, this really is like just Kubo's next 5 years. You know, the next 5 years is just going to be Kubo, Kubo, Kubo. And I can tell that Shueisha are definitely putting their mind to it. But at the end of the day, we look at this and we're like, okay, well, what is this going to be? Is this going to be like an OVA, just like a one episode thing? And if so, how do you sell it? So let's talk about what the future of Burn the Witch is at this point and what my speculation that makes sense to me. So if we are getting a Burn the Witch Season 2, which I'm very absolutely positively sure that this is going to be the case, I genuinely think because Burn the Witch did so well in theatres, I do believe, because obviously Burn the Witch was re-aired on theatres twice and the manga was a success, I think in order to promote the manga, which will be returning to Weekly Shonen Jump, they need something to build up that hype. And I think to build up that hype is going to be a re-release at the theatres and maybe TV, depending on whichever way they want to go. If it's TV, it's TV. 4 episodes on TV Tokyo, Bob's your uncle, sorted, right? If it's in theatres, I think that this is the most plausible case of action, because then, one, you've got a full hour and a half in comparison to Burn the Witch's original, like, hour and, like, 5 minute time run. Why I say this is because not only do you get to re-air Burn the Witch in theatres, but you also have an incentive for it by showcasing this perhaps a 30 minute episode, right, of the prologue, considering it is quite lengthy in chapters. So now you can get caught up to 4 episodes worth of Burn the Witch, and I would imagine that it might be even to the extent of re-edited, depending on how they want to go about, you know, showing Nini's billboard getting destroyed and the West Branch thing being destroyed, and obviously seeing the world's like panties towards the end. These are all things that happened in chapter 0, so there's probably going to be like some re-editing going on, and that's plausible as well. So it would make sense to give an initiative for theatre release that can go as the campaign, then we get the manga, then we get the rest of the season 2 anime. And I do believe that this is the perfect way to get people hyped and involved yet again within the Burn the Witch series. And of course, it helps boost up for manga sales as well for Burn the Witch, and then whatever manga comes for volume 2 later on. So that's my prediction on the route that they're going to go with this. Anyways, what are they going to release this on? Is it going to be one episode and like that's it? You're going to put it on TV? I highly doubt. Are you going to give it to streaming platforms? Well, that's risky. I conclude that it's going to be in theatres, and it's going to be included with the other 3 episodes, and it's going to be merged and edited really nicely. And then that will be a great campaign starter for when season 2 or the manga wants to reiterate itself. So that's my overall conclusion on this. I love this. This is such an amazing PV. It looks great. Nini is back, the best new gen shonen. He's back to take the crown yet again. And I'm excited because it's Burn the Witch time now. So it is good to have that buffer for when we wait for Bleach Core 3. And I hope that they actually use this as an example to give Core 3 some time, some leg room, and to keep the Bleach fans happy while we wait for that. And yeah, I'm just, this is good news. Like, there's just, this is really great. In terms of the trailer, I mean, besides from those 3 specific things, I see just following the manga as normal. But those interesting, like, little filler parts of, like, running away from the paparazzi and whatnot, I wonder how they're going to change the story. Other than that, do we have a release date? No. If you were to ask me when I think we're going to get a release date, I would say wait until the end of Core 2. That's when I think we're going to hear more about Burn the Witch, right? That's something I've said on Twitter before. So let's wait until after Core 2 and then we'll kind of get our bearings in check. But realistically, to end this all off, like, you don't do a 30-minute anime episode just to do a 30-minute anime episode. You have to make your money back somehow. So how is it going to make its money back? Theatre release. There's no other way. Unless, like, TV Tokyo really just wants to waste all that money and put it on TV just for advertisements and potential, like, reselling of, like, I don't know, a Blu-ray box set. I don't see it. I definitely see a theatre release here. It's the only thing that makes sense to me currently. Because, again, what else? Like, you just don't do a 30-minute episode on its own. You just don't. Like, on its own, how are you going to get your money back? How? I'm asking you, the audience, how do you get your money back? And also, why is 0.8? That is such a weird name to call it, like, 0.8. Like, it's literally called 0.8 Don't Judge a Book by Its Cover. Like, what a name. Like, just call it 0. Burn the Witch 0? Burn the Witch 0. Okay. Okay, Kubo. Okay, do you know what? There's probably a method to your madness. Okay, I'll let you cook. I'll let you cook. But more Nini Spangaru and more Noel Nahashi. I'm sorry, boys. I'm going to cause a war in the comment section. I don't care. Nini is best girl. You're all fucking wrong unless you're a Nini stan. Noel's peak. Like, I'm not going to argue with any of you. The facts are there. I'm looking at the facts. Noel is peak. But Nini is peaker, right? I don't make the rules. I enforce them. I'm sorry, the agenda is here, right? But you can argue in the comment section about that, and there's only one winning side, so pick wisely. With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have these fine David Hanson. As always, people, get hyped, Burn the Witch's back, baby, and yeah, like, I love this. This was great. All right, peace out.